Hey, you know, the truth is you're probably here watching the video right now because you're not sure if your man loves you. You're looking for signs that he loves you deeply. One of the skills that I teach women is how to read a man's signs because you want to be able to interpret how he's acting and understand what he's feeling. Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo from DatingFire.com and DatingAdviceGuru.com. That's what we're talking about today. We're going to talk about 17 signs he loves you deeply. And before this rocket lifts off from the pad, I want you to do that big three you know and love so much. Number one, make sure you like and subscribe to the videos if you like it. Hey, why wouldn't you? And of course, make sure you turn on notifications so you know when the next one comes out. And if you have any questions or comments, or if you have a video you'd like me to do, leave that down in the comment section below. So why doesn't the guy tell you he loves you deeply? Well, first of all, you're probably wondering why men don't talk about this, why we don't say we love you more. The fact is that men simply don't express their emotions as often or in the same way as women do. Now, that shouldn't be a surprise to you, right? And that should actually be enough of an answer. We're different. In fact, men don't express feelings and emotions the same way women do. But almost every single woman wishes he would and probably wants to change a guy so that he will express his feelings like that. If you cling to this desire for men to behave just like you or other women, you're always going to be unhappy. The key to finding happiness with a man is to understand that he will never do everything the way you want him to do it. Okay? It's just a fact. If we try to change people, well, if you try to change him, he's probably going to leave eventually. So does he feel safe talking to you? This is really the most important factor. Most men would talk more about their feelings if they felt safe doing so. Now, I'm going to come back to this a bit because it's such an important point that you don't want to miss it. A lot of men are nervous about revealing their emotions because they're afraid of saying them wrong. He does want to express love. He just never wants to look like a fool for having done it. And if you think about it, what would him saying he loves you really prove? Can you believe every word a man says? No, you can't. Not because every man is a liar, but because he won't always express every emotion that he feels. So ultimately, the best way to figure out if he loves you, deeply loves you, is to know how to read him better than he knows himself. So let's get into those signs right now. Sign number one, he goes for PDA more than you do. One of the best signs a man is deeply in love with you and into you is when he's the one seeking more physical contact. PDA is just another way of saying public display of affection, right? When a man is affectionate physically, that means he's also emotionally connected to you. A man equates love with physical intimacy. Really important thing to remember, which means that if he doesn't feel physically connected to you, he's going to feel unsafe and disconnected, and he's going to put up walls between you. And yes, this also means sexually. This is where many women make a huge mistake. When you withhold any kind of sexual intimacy from your man and your relationship, he's going to interpret that to mean that you do not love him. All right, that's a clear way of just saying, I don't love you. And he gets this message right away, even if it's not the message that you're intending to send. There's a great scene in a Woody Allen movie where a man and a woman are, he and his girlfriend are shown in their separate therapy sessions, okay? And there's a split screen. Each is talking to their therapist separately. On his side, he's saying, oh my God, we hardly have sex at all. It's like three times a week. On her side, on his girlfriend's side, she says to her therapist, we have sex all the time, like three times a week. It's a perfect example of how men and women think differently about sex. Our appetites are different and our interpretations are different. So when a man is trying to get more physical affection than you, you can bet that he's deeply in love and wants that connection. Sign number two, you catch him with the googly eyes. One of the things a man has a hard time controlling is his gaze. You've probably experienced this when he looks at other women or can't keep his eyes off your chest. You get the idea, right? But you should also be on alert for when he's looking at you that way, when he's giving you the eyes. You'd be surprised. He's probably doing it more often than you think. If you're not tuned in and watching for it, you're probably going to miss it. If you catch him staring at you for no reason, that's a sign he's feeling drawn to you and attracted to you, and he's thinking about you, and that deep love is still there. Sign number three, when he goes out of his way for your interests. Guys are typically very focused on their own hobbies, but he also wants to know that you have your own. When he's interested in your hobbies, you can be sure his love for you is deeply felt. If he's asking you questions about the things you like to do, make sure you capitalize on these conversations. Talk about them in detail. Don't short circuit this because you're trying to avoid attention the way you might do it with other women. Remember, conversation with men is always going to be much different than it will be with other women. You have to start retraining yourself to respond differently if you want men to respond differently to you. Sign number four, he does the dirty work. Sure enough, one of the better signs that he's deeply in love with you is he's going to share in the housework, which is why you're probably more miffed when he doesn't do it. Instinctively, you know that he should be there helping you, chipping in the same way if he's in the relationship all the way. When either or both of you are not sharing in the responsibilities of being together, that's a warning sign that you're withdrawing behind a wall of grudge. Pulling back your effort is one of the warning signs that your relationship could be in trouble. So guys will jump in and do housework when they feel connected and loved in return. Sign number five, he comes back after the heat. One of the things that motivates men more than anything else in a relationship is making a woman happy. If you've read any of my articles, watched any of my videos, you know this to be a fact. It's a primary motivator for men. So if you have a heated conversation with him and he keeps returning to you to check in somehow, interpret that to mean that he is still there in the relationship with you. He's still got that love. You know, he might show up with a token of affection, maybe some food or a compliment. What he's trying to do is bridge that gap between you, trying to make up for things. If he isn't returning, this could be a warning sign. Sign number six, he's got a pet name. A funny little way that men show their endearment is when he comes up with little pet nicknames for you. It's like love shorthand. It's a way of him expressing love in a way that you probably miss. Nicknames are emotional shortcuts for men to find their way to their love for you. That's what it's doing. It's a quick shortcut to him connecting with his own emotion. Sign number seven is he's paying his dues. One way you can find out if he's deeply in love with you is if he demonstrates effort towards making the relationship work. Now, of course, the problem is that most women don't always spot the effort that a man makes to make it work, mostly because she's looking in a different direction. A few of the ways that men pay their dues to make a relationship work are: he brings you around his friends and family, he likes to stay close to you physically, he listens and pays attention to you, he makes himself useful in your life, maybe doing things you didn't ask for, he's ready for more after you kiss, he reaches out to you just because he wants to hear from you. He doesn't care what you do as long as you're together. Again, you might not recognize these things for what they are, but they're signs. Be open to a man expressing love in a way that is different from you or from even other women, the way they like to express it. Next sign is he rebounds. A lot of men will rebound fairly quick after an argument. According to a 2016 Harvard study, women hold grudges and stay angry longer than men do. I know this might not be a big surprise for anybody, but guys tend to return to the relationship connection much faster than women do. Be open to reconciling quicker. You may be tempted to hold on to your anger longer, but don't do it. Remember what I said about that grudge wall? If you're still not ready, you can explain it to him that you just need a little more time. But you can also take solace in knowing that if he comes back to you looking to mend or heal, that's pretty deep love. The next sign is he makes sacrifices. Guys will make small sacrifices to make the bigger relationship work. Here are a few of the ways they might do that. Taking the time to go with you to the store. Going with you to a family event that he normally might skip. Going to the grocery store with you, or helping your parents out, or helping one of your friends out. Again, it's very tempting to see a man's efforts as begrudging or reluctant if he's not excited to do them, or if he's not verbally excited about it. But you have to give him credit for when he actually does them anyways. Look at his actions, especially if you know it's not something he particularly wants to do. The next sign is much more talk. Early on in your relationship, you might notice that the talk is fairly superficial. You guys just both talk about the fun stuff for the most part. What will prove to you that your love is growing deeper is when he starts initiating more conversation about a wider variety of topics. This is a man's way of deepening the relationship. The conversations may swing from light and fluffy to deep and heavy, but the point is to have as many talks as he wants to initiate. When a man feels comfortable enough to talk to you like this, he's showing the depths of his emotions. Next sign is you share more time. Remember that no matter how busy a man is, he must make time for you, or you're not really a part of his life. There's no exception to this rule, okay? If he's not making time for you, then he is not prioritizing you. Now, this can swing out of kilter temporarily, but it has to swing back to giving you time if it's going to stay in true love, okay? This is one of the hardest things to confront when you're in a relationship with a man, and it's one of the biggest signs of deep love when he's giving it to you. When he gives you more of his time, that's like him giving of himself. Men value their time more than anything, and he will spend it with somebody he truly cares for. The next sign is you feel safe. One of the ways a man knows that you're deeply in love is when he feels safe in your presence. I mentioned this earlier, right? Safe to share his past with you, safe to share his emotions with you, safe to share his friends with you or share his world with you. And funny enough, you know you're deeply in love when you feel safe around him. you feel a sense of protection around you like a force field. One of his biological drives is to protect you as his partner. It's an evolutionary drive that he just never lost. If you feel safe enough and protected enough to do things that are outside of your comfort zone, chances are you're feeling well loved. Love gives us a stable base from which we take on new things and new experiences. Sign number 15, you believe his word. An important trait of a real man is his ability to keep his promises, and this is especially true in his relationships. If he makes you a promise, he should keep it with you. That's a very important sign of deep love and connection. Even if a guy falls back on his word because of his circumstances, he'll make it up to you. Somehow he will come through and make it up. Something else that's very important is that he probably won't make promises lightly either. A man knows that he's obligated to his word, so he's going to be careful how often he gives that out. Sign number 16, he can handle it, and you. You ever feel like you're letting your inner crazy out? Every woman does this once in a while. Sometimes it's that time of the month, sometimes you've just been pushed too far, sometimes life just drives you crazy. Your man should understand this and be okay with it. Now, it's true that men today aren't exactly educated about the ways of women as they once were, and women aren't educated in the ways of men either. However, if he's really, truly, deeply in love with you, he will find a way to handle your crazy, and he will deal with the toughest parts of you. You won't always be overjoyed at the craziness, but his love for you will carry him through it. Just one thing you have to consider, don't be high maintenance, right? His love should carry some amount of patience with it, but that doesn't mean that you should go out and unload and drive him insane either. If you notice a lot of things coming up in your relationship where you feel this craziness coming out, it might be a good idea to seek some professional help to work through some of these issues. Remember that love also has a balance in the love bank account. You don't want to make too many withdrawals at his expense, right? By the way, if PMS is an issue for you, make sure you explain to him how that works with you. A man doesn't understand the situation for women that go through these extreme hormonal and emotional pressures, and every woman's different. Explain to him what to expect and when it's coming if you can alert him, especially if it's really emotional for you, because a man will not put two and two together. He's not going to immediately understand that that's what's going on, and he might think this is completely out of the blue. He should know what's going on so he understands and gives you the space you need. Now, of course, there's a difference between grumpy and hormonal terror, right? Hopefully you know where you live on that scale and you can tell him so that he understands. Now, I couldn't cover every single one of the signs with you today. You might have noticed I had to cut a few out, but that's okay. Go on over to the site and you can read all about it. Go on over to datingfire.com and you can get the last of the signs. But right now, I'm gonna give you sign number 17. The judge has left the building. Sometimes we fall into judging our behavior in our relationships. What's dangerous is when we judge our partner frequently. When he loves you deeply, he will not judge you or make you feel judged. However, your personalities are not well matched or you're not compatible, that judginess will probably show up frequently. And that's a warning sign that perhaps you're in love, but you can't be in a relationship with that person. It does happen. Just notice yourself when you start to judge him. Do you want to change him? Do you want him to live according to your standards? Do you feel the need to correct his behavior? Remember, these are all warning signs of a relationship that could be turning unhealthy. Sometimes you just got to say, he's not for me. Don't try to change him into the guy that you think is right for you. I've got one bonus sign for you here today, and that is you're on the same road. And it goes without saying that a relationship means you're both together, kind of like being in the same car together. And just as important as being in the same car is that you're heading in the same direction, at least on the same road, right? A lot of couples assume that just because they're in a relationship, this means they must be sharing the same goals, dreams, and aspirations. And it's only many years down that road that they discover they never really talked about it, and they were never really on board with each other. They never actually agreed on the most important thing, where they were going on this journey. Falling in love is easy. Falling in love and then transitioning that love into a relationship that stands the test of time, that's hard. It's time we started focusing on the most important part of relationships, the work that's needed to make it work. Now, nobody wants to think about it as being work, right? Funny enough, it's not really all that hard to make sure you're going in the same direction. It's actually a skill. Women are mostly all too happy to share this journey. The one thing that most women forget to do or simply don't know how to do is connect with a guy. That's the most essential step in sharing this ride together. If you can be connected with him, you're going to make sure that you stand the test of time, that things stay connected, that even when things get difficult, he's going to be there for you. And if you want to make it work, you got to really know how to make him see you as his forever woman. You've got to really be able to make that connection that makes him go, ah, she gets me like no other woman does. Because that's the secret sign that men are looking for. We're looking for that little secret click of the key in the lock that goes, ah, she gets me. She understands me. And honestly, most women just don't know how to do that. It's not that hard if you know what he's looking for. What are the little tumblers in that lock that click when the key finally turns? That's what your goal is. That's what you really need to understand. How does he feel that sense of click? Oh yeah, we got a connection here. I'm not gonna do anything to mess this up. That's the key difference right there, if you'll pardon the pun. That's the key difference between relationships that work and the relationships that don't work. The woman learns how to make that key fit his lock. That connection is so important that it's the only thing he looks for when it comes time to make that decision. Is she going to stay a girlfriend or a booty call, or is she going to actually be my wife or my long-term committed partner? Remember, men don't make this decision consciously. It's all done very below the surface, very subconscious. And if you want to be able to trigger that subconscious feeling in him that he's connected with you, you got to know how it works in his head. You got to know how that lock works in his heart. Deep love is not tricky to create. It's all coming from deep connection. If you want to know how that works, I've got a great resource for you, and it's free. The best part is you can even ask me a question while you're doing it. Go on over to datingfire.com/AskCarlos. That's datingfire.com/AskCarlos. Even if you don't have a question, no big deal. Go on over, put your email in, and I'm going to send you some great free stuff. I'll send you some, I've got free videos, I've got some newsletter, I've got a PDF file, an ebook that you can get all for free that I'll send you on 7 deadly mistakes that women make that break that connection. Because that's really what it's all about, isn't it? If you don't make the mistakes, you're at least halfway there. You're actually more like 3/4 or 90% of the way there if you don't make the mistakes, because that's what really turns a guy off and what ultimately makes him disconnect from you. I'll tell you the real reason that men run from relationships, how to know if he's still interested in you, and if a guy is afraid to commit. If you want to find out what those 7 mistakes are that make men pull away, go on over to datingfire.com/AskCarlos. You can put in a question. Can't guarantee I'm going to answer, but I will definitely give it some thought. And if it's unique, I might even do a video for it. And before you run off to watch the next Carlos video, make sure you do the big 3. Make sure you like and subscribe to the videos. If you like this and you're here right now, you obviously did, do it. Just make sure you subscribe. And of course, turn on notifications so you know when the next one comes out. And of course, if you have any other questions, make sure to leave those in the comments below. And, you know, as I always say, live and love with passion.